Here at UPEI, over 1,800 full-time students are taking courses that lead to bachelor degrees in arts, science, education, music, and business administration. And this year, 52 additional students are registered in the very first class of the Atlantic Veterinary College, a faculty of the University of Prince Edward Island. Of these, 10 are from Prince Edward Island, 16 from Nova Scotia, 13 from New Brunswick, and 2 from Newfoundland. Students at UPEI are also taking pre-professional programs, that is, courses that lead to degrees in medicine, dentistry, veterinary medicine, engineering, law, agriculture, and architecture. We want to introduce you to many of our freshman students. This is what life is like at the Island University. What program are you taking at UPEI?
I'm registered for the arts faculty.
Do you find that the program here has what you need in a post-secondary education? Did it meet your expectations?
Yep, I think it has what I need.
What are you most interested in going on and doing later on?
I'm thinking about psychology.
Sometimes at high school you find that your teachers are very receptive to you. They know what's mm-hmm. going on with you all the time. At university it's a little bit more impersonal in that professors mm-hmm. have so many students to deal with. Do you find that here?
Well, it's more impersonal than high school, but it's probably more personal than larger universities, I'd say. Because the student-teacher, student-professor ratio, I guess, is pretty low.
Laurie, you've been here 3 weeks now. What do you like most so far?
The freedom and the friends and everything. It's a fun part of university.
Rachel, you're in French immersion. Tell us a little bit about your program.
French immersion lasts 5 days a week from 9 to 12, and it's really interesting. I have three different professors, and each one for an hour every day, and each one teaches in a different way, so you're exposed to different French. It's pretty good.
And so that you don't speak any English during that time period?
When we get stuck, we speak English, but we try and keep on speaking French.
what made your decision to come to UPEI to take French immersion?
I decided to come to UPEI because it was closer to home and because there was a scholarship available, which helped a lot. And it was seemed closer to home, and I thought it'd be good to come here.
Who helped you make that decision? Was that family and friends helped you make the decision, or was it people at West Isle? Who was it?
My teachers at West Isle and friends. There was a lot of people coming here, and the French program seemed like interesting here, so I decided to take it.
What do you hope to do now with this program when you're finished?
I'm hoping to get a BA in French. Eventually, maybe teach younger kids, maybe elementary school level in French.
Tell us about the attitude of the professors here. Are they good people to work with and to work for, in effect, I suppose? Are they receptive to helping students and so forth?
Yes, I think they are. They, if you need any help, like after class, like they're always willing to help you after class. It's just you have to show that you're interested. Like, it's not so much they're trying to find out if you are. You have to show them. You have to prove to them that you're interested, and they'll help you if you want the help.
Besides your scholarship, how else will you help finance your university education? Because it's an expensive proposition.
Yes, that's for sure. I started working at Tim Hortons part-time, so I've been pretty busy. I work supposedly working part-time, but I've been working like 7 days in a row. but I'll put it in the bank and hopefully I'll be able to pay for it. I have got a student loan, so that helped. But so far, so good. Not had to spend money down here, though.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Yeah.
Tell us the last question, Rachel, and that is 4 weeks at university so far. Mm-hmm. How have you found it?
So far, it's been great. I mean, my parents keep saying, when are you coming home?
This fall of 1986, we have 632 freshmen registered at the university, many on scholarships offered exclusively to freshmen. For instance, the university offers at least one entrance scholarship to each high school in Prince Edward Island, valued at $3,000. Besides, UPEI gives approximately 80 scholarships, valued from $500 to $2,250 to first-year students. Ask your guidance counselor about the UPEI scholarship program.
What about, you talked about a scholarship. How does the scholarship work? And is there an incentive for you to keep your marks up in order to retain the scholarship?
Oh, yeah. You have to keep it up because you have to maintain a 75 average your first year and then 80% your second year. And second year is a lot harder than first year, so your first year is where you really have to make your marks. Because the better your marks are, the better the job opportunities are.
What does an engineer do in this university in terms of summer employment? Do you have to get some practical experience in the summertime?
Not necessarily, but it is good. If you take surveying, you can get a job working on the roads with some of the people, and that does go good for your engineering job later on in the years.
I know that financing university education is tough, even if you do have a scholarship. How do you finance your education?
Well, Mom and Dad pay for most of it, and I got a scholarship for my marks from high school, so high school marks do pay off. If you work at it, you do get scholarships offered.
What about part-time or summer jobs? Do you have a summer job?
Yeah, I work at McDonald's family restaurant here in Charlottetown, and in the summer I work down at Summerside, so I can just switch back and forth to stores.
And you help with that, really helps out?
Yeah.
Is it another thing on budgeting your time? Obviously it takes
some. Yeah, it takes about 15 hours a week. Plus there's the socializing with people and your friends. You want to go out with your friends. And then they're studying, so you barely have any time to do anything.
What is there good about UPEI besides academics? What else is there that's really good about it?
Well, the sports here are very good. They're very good in sports. As I said before, the hospitality, like people are just come up to you and say hi. You don't even know them. They say hi to you, and you just say hi back. Say, who's that, you know? They just come up to you. And everybody offers you stuff. Like when you're living in the residence, people come over and say hi, they drop in and they talk to you, they be sociable. So you meet a lot of new people in university.
Do you like living in residence?
Of course, yes, it's great. There's a lot of people coming and going, and it does sometimes disrupt your studies, but that's what the library is for. You come to the library and study.
Okay, if you had to sum up your first 4 weeks at UPEI, how would you say it? You know, what's the best thing about it for you?
Exciting, different. Fun, a lot of parties, and it's basically you're all on your own.
What about the university itself? Did it offer you a scholarship to induce you to come here at all?
Yes, it did. It was an academic scholarship.
Can you explain how it works?
In a scholarship, it's based not only on your merits, but also on your school and community involvement. And my type of scholarship was also based on an interview. There was three girls chosen from our school who had the interview. And I was chosen from one of the scholarships.
So it helps out a lot.
Oh, I guess so. It's very expensive.
How about you live in residence, don't you?
Yes.
Tell us about that. How do you find it?
It's fun. That's all I can say. It's a lot different from home because you have to do all your own things, but you're close to the university. You're not traveling back and forth. You're not wasting time that way.
Do you find that you meet a lot of new people at residence?
Yeah. Not only people from the island, there's people from all over Canada here.
At high school, I know teachers keep a constant watch on people, and they're concerned about their education. Do you find that here at this university from your experience so far? Are the professors concerned about you?
They are concerned, but they're not being mother hens, so to say. They want you to do your own work, and they're not going to force you to do it because it's you that's paying for it. But they are concerned, and they'll help you with anything basically that you need help in.
Here at UPEI, students find many services designed to meet their needs. For instance, scholarship and financial aid, a reading lab, a chaplaincy center, a medical center, a Canada Employment Center, off-campus housing, and student counseling.
What about academically? What are you interested in and what are you taking? And do you find that the university offers you what you need in terms of your academic career?
Well, I'm going into home ec. Right now, I'm just taking one home ec course and then a science like chemistry, English, math, and sociology. I find, I've heard from different people that the home ec course here at UPEI is just as good as anywhere else. It's a small university, but still, I think it's good. It's supposed to be good, so.
What are your goals? Do you want to finish your educational career at UPEI, or is there a kind of desire for you to go on to another university when you finish?
No, I think I'll finish it here at UPEI. I don't know. I would like to become a dietitian. It's hard to say right now, but as far as I know, I will be here at UPEI. Yeah.
What do you personally want to get out of a university education?
I want to get a job when I get out of here. It is different. It is different from high school. You have all this free time. It's up to you to do the studying. No one's after you to keep up your studies and that. No, I hope after I get out of here, I'll be able to find some job that I like working at for life.
Mary, what made you decide to come to UPEI?
Well, I'm taking business administration, and from what I've heard, UPEI is about the best place in the Maritimes to take business, so I decided to go here.
What kinds of courses are you taking?
I'm taking economics, business administration, computers, University 100, math. Computers is new for me because I never took computers at all in high school, so programming that is totally different. And then I'm taking University 100, which is a new course. It's in place of an English, if your English marks are high enough in the course. It just teaches you about the new things in university, what university life is like, how to approach it, and how to succeed.
Do you find that in this program that the professors care about your progress, where you're going?
They do care. They want you to succeed. They try to teach you what you need to know to get ahead. I mean, they know it's competitive and probably somebody here is trying to beat somebody else, but I think everybody in the long run wants to help each other, and the professors want to help you too. You just have to go look for the help and they'll give it. They want your progress as much as you do.
What would you say is maybe your fondest recollection of your first month here at university? What to pinpoint the thing that you like the most about it?
Meeting so many different people. I think there's so many different people from everywhere, all across the country, in different countries. Before, you're just used to the same atmosphere, the same people, but now you're getting out on your own, meeting many different people, and it's a whole new experience. It's great.
Would you have missed it?
No, I wouldn't have missed university for anything.
Here at UPEI, 450 students are living in attractive residences on campus. They're having good times they'll always remember. UPEI has three residences, Bernardine Hall, Marion Hall, and an apartment-style residence, Blanchard Hall. There are over 110 full-time professors at the Island University. Tuition for the 1986-87 academic year is $1,480.
Is there, I know that you're in a discipline that requires a lot of practice and things like
that.
Yeah, a lot. Do you, in fact, have to be a disciplined individual when you're living in residence? Because there are other things to kind of distract you.
Yeah, I do, because my friends, they go out, and I have to say, no, I can't go, I have to practice.
How about the music faculty here? What does it offer to you when you're finished? What can you do?
Well, I can teach, but I don't know. I think I'm probably going to go on and study more so I can do more, like perform maybe.
Okay, what's the difference between Three Oaks and UPEI in terms of, say, relationships with teachers? Is there a kind of less contact with your teacher here?
No, because with me I have the same teachers all the time, so you really get to know them and you get along really good with them, just like at 3O.
Do you find that the faculty here, the teachers, care about you as a student and your progress?
Yeah, I do. They're always asking if you have any problems to come see them.
Right. What about your funding of your university education? You're not on a scholarship,
no.
Are you? How do you get by? Because the university education is so expensive these days.
Well, I have a student loan,
right,
and it pays for everything.
Right. Do you have to, do you have a summer job or anything like that? What do you do in the summertime?
Well, last summer I worked at Bun King, but I don't know what I'm going to do this summer. Like, I'll probably try to do something related to music.
A university sometimes brings people not only from the island together, from all different parts of the island, but all different parts of the country. Do you find that at the university, and do you like that atmosphere?
Yeah, well, I met a few people from away, other provinces, Canada.
And do you like the...
Yeah, it's really good. I have a roommate who's from Lebanon. It's really neat because she tells us about her culture and stuff.
Who helped you make your decision on coming to university? Not particularly this one, but any university.
I think it was, well, my parents partly, but it was mostly my own decision.
What about guidance counselors and so forth? Did they guide you in ways to go, in programs to choose?
Yeah, we discussed things with our guidance counselors and decided what our interests were and how they could be applied to university.
You're in the Faculty of Education, is that right?
Yeah.
What goes on, and what are the prospects? How many years is it for you now, and what are the prospects at the end of the 4 years?
Well, it's 4 years, and then you could get your master's with one more year. And after that, it's possible you could get a teaching job. And what I'd like to do is move off the island, maybe out west or something like that, and get a teaching job there in a high school.
You're from Kincora.
Well, I went to school there. Yeah.
Are you living in residence this year?
Mm-hmm.
How do you find that experience?
I love it. I think it's great.
What's the best part of the residence?
I think it's living with a bunch of people your own age, mainly, and just you're there in your own free will, and it's just great.
Here at UPEI, students sit on the two governing bodies, that is, on the Senate and on the Board of Governors. As well, students sit on all committees of Senate and the Board.
Bob, you first. When did you make your decision that you were going to come to UPEI this year?
Well, I got in contact with the guidance counselor at Bluefield, and I was speaking with her for a while and trying to decide where I'd go. And
I guess early spring, the applications came out for UPEI, and at the same time, applications for scholarships came out, so I applied for scholarship. And during the time that I got between applying and receiving and knowing that I had gotten it, I decided that I'd like to stay at UPEI for at least 1 year anyway and get used to the university.
You guys have both got similar aspirations. Can you explain a little bit about that, Tom, and what your experience here at UPEI will eventually lead to?
That's right. We both are interested in the field of broadcasting. And basically what we wanted was 1 year of university close to home, local university, where we could gain some experience and maturity, and then next year go to Ryerson in Ontario, where we would get a degree in bachelor radio and television arts.
How are you using this year to prepare yourself, Bob? What are you taking this year, and are you finding that it's meeting what you need?
Well, there's a few reasons why I'm staying here. Some reasons are for the courses. There's some arts courses that you can pick up here that will only help you when you go up to Ontario to take the Ryerson course. As well, I have some broadcast experience here with the radio station on campus, so I plan to get involved in that too. And I guess by spending another year on the island, you can become, a more rounded university student when you eventually do go to Ryerson.
If you had to kind of sum up, Tom, what your experience has been so far in 3 weeks, it's not much time, what's the best thing about it?
I don't know. I guess the free time, the restrictions aren't placed on you like they are in high school. There's more free time. You're more available to do other things other than just the studying, although that is important. But basically, it's the free time.
In the first class of the Doctor of Veterinary Medicine program at the Atlantic Veterinary College is Jane Hogan of Morrell, PEI. She graduated from UPEI in 1983 with a Bachelor of Science degree. However, any student with an equivalent of 3 years study at any university may be eligible for admission into the first year of the program at ABC. Jane now is a freshman for the second time, and this was her response when asked about the difference.
The major change that I find is just study-wise. I thought it'd be really hard to get back into the study and with the full course load, but I don't know if it's mainly because you kind of got a final goal in sight now and you don't mind sitting down and putting in long hours of studying, which you have to do, I find, because just to keep up, because you're expected to, once you get into like a professional type school, you're expected to do a lot of, background research on your own. So you have to kind of sit down and decide that you're going to put in a lot of time studying. So that's what I find the main thing. It's not such a hassle or such a chore for me to sit down and study now.
Mm-hmm. Your general impressions, how has it been?
In the veterinarian universe? I've enjoyed it a lot. They shoved us right into the workload. They didn't waste any time, but it's going to be a good program. The professors, I find, are very professional, and they're very good professors. And they make it they're giving their all, so you're going to give your all type thing. And I'm really excited about it. The more I hear about it and what we'll be doing 4 years down the road, it's an initiative to get in there and study type thing.
I'm wondering, did you always intend to pursue veterinary medicine?
I grew up on a farm, and that was my main initiative when I came to UPI, was to study for veterinary medicine. But then I find from your first year to your fourth year in undergrad, you change your mind a lot. And I wasn't any different than anybody else. I had different, I was looking into physiotherapy, and I was looking into dentistry, and even as much as law.
Well, what factors did you weigh in deciding to come here as opposed to, say, maybe the University of New Brunswick and so forth?
It was a lot closer and more easy to travel back and forth to home. And since it would be my first year, I don't know how much I would like university. And so if I ever decided to quit or if there's any ever problems, I'd be right close to home. And in addition, my brothers, Pius and Lee, they both went here. And so they give me experience with the campus and the teachers, the professors. And
kind of interested, you mentioned that you weren't sure whether you'd like university or not.
Mm.
You've been here 3 weeks now. What are your impressions so far?
I like university. It's a lot different from high school, but the differences are better. There's more freedom, there's more things to get involved in, and generally more free time, which I enjoy.
You're living in residence. How have you found that so far?
Residence is challenging, exciting, and a whole bunch of fun. We had a house party just a couple of weeks into the year, and it was a whole bunch of fun.
Is this your first time away from home for a long period of time?
Yes, it is. My first time.
I'm wondering about some of the maybe more practical things about living in residence, budgeting money and doing all the kind of day-to-day type things that might not have been done before at home or done by somebody else. How have you found that?
Well, that's the challenging part, is going through your day-to-day things like your laundry and your meals, which I find quite different from home because I eat here at the cafeteria. And so that's the most challenging aspect of it, is the food, I think. Big change.
Would you consider maybe next year staying in residence, or maybe next year would you want to, say, move off campus and live in private housing?
I'm interested in Blanchard. It's much different from Marion in that you can cook your own meals. It's more of an apartment-style housing, and I'd like to try that before moving off campus.
UPEI, I know I've covered sports here for a couple of years anyway. It seems to be alive. There seem to be a lot of things going on. Do you find that out of the classroom? Is there a lot going on for you?
Yes, there is. As you say, there's university sports, but even a pickup game of football down the field there. And, of course, the Soccer Panthers, which I enjoy to watch on Saturdays. It's a lot of fun, and it's great to get out there and support your team.
What does this university offer you in terms of academics? What program are you in, and where do you want it to lead you?
I'm currently enrolled in an arts program with a heavy science lean, taking chemistry, physics, and calculus. And I think that in a small campus like this, I can learn the basics better than perhaps in some other larger university, where they're teacher to student ratio isn't as large, and I may not get as much lab time and attention.
Are you on scholarship?
Yes, I am.
How did that help you make your decision to come to university?
It helped very much because I was only offered a scholarship here, and since I don't come from a wealthy background, it helped quite a bit.
I know Dr. Elliott, the president of the university, is a man who's sometimes very eloquent in expressing what the university is supposed to be about. For you, what is a university education supposed to mean?
It's supposed to mean the basics and yet a whole bunch more. There has to be the sports, there has to be the teams, there has to be spirit. And at Marion Hall and here on campus, I enjoy that spirit very much.
Some things will never change. That's just the way it is. That's just the way it is.
Close to 7,000 graduates of UPEI are realizing their early hopes and goals at home and abroad, in the professions, in business and industry, and at the finest graduate schools everywhere. Their years spent on a small, intimate campus have been enriched by new and valuable friendships, dedicated professors, and an appetite for scholarship. The UPEI grad is now prepared for a useful and rewarding life moving towards the exciting 21st century. How about you?